I was 18 years old when I moved to Germany. Did I have a clear thought through plan? Absolutely not. Do I wish there was someone there to guide me? Definitely yes. So that is exactly what I'm going to do for you. In this video, we will look at the three most important pros and cons of moving abroad to help you decide what is the right path for you. We would also cover some of the most common questions that I get asked. For example, if you can come for a job directly or should you apply for a study program first? I'll be posting a lot more videos to help you find a job or a study program abroad. So if you haven't already, please take the time to subscribe to my channel. If you have a particular question like how to find a study program in Europe that is completely free, or what European and American companies hire directly from wherever you are in the world, please leave me a short comment below with your question and I will try my best to help you. All right, let's get to it. So what are the pros and cons of moving abroad? The first, and in my mind, the most important benefit is diversity. You will meet people from all around the world who would each have very different ideas, and this will help open up your mind in every way possible. It would teach you to think differently, and that has all the potential of changing your life. I, for example, learned to talk to women. You may laugh, but I swear it was a challenge coming from an all-boys school in a very conservative country. I also learned the cultural differences in natives of different countries across the globe that allows me to successfully manage the very diverse members of my team at Amazon today. On the other hand, this increases the likelihood of you developing a different mindset to the dear ones you have left behind at home. Between my mother asking me not to watch Bollywood music videos because the women weren't fully dressed, to the completely naked mixed saunas of Germany, life did get confusing at times. Now that may be an extreme example, but let's just say you might have to answer your parents' questions on why you need to fall in love before you get married rather than after it. The second benefit I would say is the career opportunities. There are definitely much more of those in the developed world, whichever way you look at it. As a supply chain enthusiast, Amazon was definitely a dream company for me, so that's where I went. But I'm sure there are many people who would love to work for the likes of Google, Tesla, basically whatever is the best in the world for your respective field. It's pretty cool in terms of compensation too. I was earning a six-figure salary by my fourth year already. I wouldn't have even earned a fraction of that had I not moved to Europe. And when I needed to send money home to support my family, the euro to rupee conversion rate was just a lifesaver. Being able to buy my dream car and in general, the lifestyle that I can enjoy today, I believe would not have been possible otherwise. The negative side of this is that you are often far away from family and friends. And trust me, that is a huge sacrifice. You miss things you didn't even know you liked when you were back home. And while it mostly gets easier for you with time, it isn't always the case for those you leave behind. Mothers in particular. Mine went through a very rough time as all four of our sons moved abroad to different parts of the world. It was not sustainable. We were very worried for her. If my brother had not wanted to move back home, as much as I love my life in Europe, I would have left everything and moved back without the blink of an eye. This is something you definitely need to take into consideration. Last but not the least is the benefit of freedom. Branching out on your own is definitely a booster for becoming independent and growing your own wings. As they say, you cannot learn to fly without leaving the nest. And when the diversity of your experiences and the financial independence from points 1 and 2 are accomplished by a strong passport, the world is your oyster. I did not know freedom till I got my German passport and could randomly decide to fly to almost any country in the world at any moment. Worrying about visas and planning in advance became things of the past. I once walked to a different country by mistake. The possibilities are limitless. The other side of this, of course, is leaving your comfort zone behind. All the magic of the world fades away when you have to clean your own toilet for the first time. Whether you will miss your mom's favorite recipes more or the comfort of having a maid at home, there will definitely be some luxuries you will need to sacrifice for a bit. It does get easier with time as you find friends that love cooking for some strange reason and potentially hire a cleaning service. But there are still times when you will miss home, whether it's Eid, Diwali, or Christmas. Alright, now that you know what to expect and have some stuff to think through, let me take the liberty of sharing my own advice. I am a strong believer that everyone should at least once in their life move abroad. It's one of the best learning experiences life has to offer. Whether it's from China to the US or from France to India, we should all take that leap. Because outside our comfort zone, that's where the magic happens. But what about all the cons we just went through, you ask? My advice is to use them to determine what and how long do you move abroad for. Let me explain with some examples. If you are the kind of person who truly wants all the benefits that the experience has to offer, especially the diversity and open-mindedness of it, and at the same time are brave enough to face and overcome the challenges, then you should aim to go abroad as quickly as possible, ideally for a bachelor's degree already. Moving abroad at a younger age allows you to integrate better as you're not yet set in your own ways. You will end up having much more diverse group of friends and attending weddings and celebrations with their families, which just really show you the other side of the world in depth. This is what I experienced personally. Living on campus with nationals of over 100 different countries allowed me to make friends from countries that I didn't even know existed. And to this day, I know that if I ever need help or a place to crash in any part of the world, all I need to do is a quick Facebook search. This is what really expands your comfort zone and makes you a true citizen of the world. In contrast, when you come for a master's degree or for a job directly, you have much less interaction with other cultures. And secondly, you yourself are much more set in your own ways by then. You don't have the curiosity or energy of a teenager anymore. The worries of life are real already, and you're fully focused on the future. Now, in a different example, if you're more concerned about the cons of moving abroad, like the mindset gap, homesickness, etc., in comparison to the benefits that the diverse experiences and better integration brings, then the right step for you would be to either go for a master's degree or even a job directly. I have a lot of friends that followed this path. While it does make it a little bit more difficult to integrate and to be comfortable longer term, it does have its benefits. You will still stay more closely connected to your own culture and people from your own country, making it easier and more likely for you to return back home. This is especially helpful if your situation demands this as well. For example, strict parents or an only child. Between coming for a master's degree and directly for a job, it's still the same factors that you should consider, along with some consideration for the fact that a degree from the destination country does make it a bit easier to find a job. However, considering how often I get this question, if what you're really looking for is just a job, please don't give up and apply for study programs just because someone told you that it's impossible to get a job without it. It really is not. A lot of big multinationals, including Amazon, do their hiring directly from across the world with remote interviews and sponsored long-term visas. I personally have interviewed hundreds of remote candidates and hired many of them directly from their remote locations for my teams at Amazon. I hope this video helped you gain some clarity on what is the right path for you. If you're looking to move abroad, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I will be posting a lot more in-depth guidance on the processes and tips to get admissions, interviews, jobs, visas, and potentially even a new nationality. If you have any particular questions or specific topics you would like me to cover, please leave a comment below and I will get back to you. I hope to see you soon with another helpful video. Till then, take care.